Hello, this is Mohammed here and welcome to this section. Here I'm going to talk about the details on Oracle mobile supply chain application, and we'll go through the architecture details. So before I get to that point, I'm going to talk about a little bit on what does this application work like, how does it work, what does it do. So as you can see, there are pictures of a couple of RF devices. These are called radio frequency devices, or ultimately they are a kind of just like a cell phone, but a big cell phone which can connect to the internet, and they do have buttons, as used to be in the BlackBerry old buttons. So they do have buttons for keying in the data, as well as it has a scanner on the top and a button to press that scanner to activate that scanner. So what it does is it opens up the MSCA telnet screen, and I'll talk about that later in details. And also, once that is entered, the scanner is used to scan the barcode. So there are different kinds of scanners. It could be 2D enabled or a single one-dimensional barcode reader as well. But nowadays, most of the barcode readers are two-dimensional. So that will let you scan a 2D barcode rather than a one-dimensional barcode. Okay, so first thing is the mobile devices needs to run the Oracle application. So right now, if people are using Oracle application on the desktop version of it, like they are typically running the Oracle forms, and if you are on the newest version of Oracle, then probably you would be using the Internet Explorer or the web browsers to access the functionalities or different functions in different modules. But ultimately, the mobile or the RF guns are used to run most of the time the telnet version or the text-based version. There are also graphical user interface version of MSCA, and I'll talk about that in later sections. But that is typically not used because of the load speed, and they are not very much fast or quick as compared to the text-based. So people prefer the text-based navigation, and I'll talk through that in the later subsequent chapters. Next thing is the warehouse transactions can be performed on the wireless radio frequency device or Wi-Fi. So they are connected to the Wi-Fi typically in the warehouse or in the manufacturing facility where you are doing those transactions. These devices are connected to the wireless network of that particular organization. So what it does is it lets the users, or it lets the business users, do those transactions on this screen. So you can see there is another form of the device sold by a particular company. I think they are partnered with Zebra. So what you can do, they are Android based device, so it's very, very convenient, easy. It has a long range. So the difference between these two is this particular device will have a longer range of scanning, but this device will not have that long range of scanning. So this device maybe can scan up to 30 to 40 feet. So it's always good and easy for people working in a big warehouses where there are multiple racks, and they don't need to like reach out directly to the racks, so they can scan at a distance, and it makes things really easier. Next thing, the functionality of these devices is to make the transaction smooth and to the point, and they can be done at the time of having those transactions. So the transactions gets processed absolutely immediately, and it's called a synchronous transaction. So the scanner is basically, again, we will go to details in the next slide that will talk about how do we do these transactions talk to Oracle main ERP system. And in the last point I wanted to mention is it still uses the telnet protocol. And if you Google about telnet protocol, it's one of the oldest protocol developed for the device communication. So what it means is it uses technology that was built in 1969 to do a text-based two-way communication between two devices. So here, basically this device or this device or this device is trying to communicate it to with the mobile server. And again, I'll talk to you in the next slide. So this device exchanges data in a text-based format, and it basically do the back and forth data communication. And this is still considered a little bit of from cybersecurity standpoint, it's still not a very recommended way, because the data is not encrypted. That means anybody can intercept this data and they can get the information, they can hack the information. But still, most of the companies use it just because there is no other alternative to this technology at this point, unless you want to have some kind of encryption logic added on top of it. Or in most of the cases, this is still being practiced just because most of these networks are company owned and they do have firewalls built in, so they are less susceptible for cybersecurity hacks. But still, these are still an open vulnerability in the networking troposphere. So going to the next slide, who is this for? So this is great for people who are trying to start their career in Oracle applications as a functional or a developer role, and they want to build their career as a consultant or as a analyst to help support other businesses. This can be also used for the business folks who want to learn more about this and want to know how can we effectively use in our day-to-day operations. And typically a warehouse manager or a person who leads a team of people who work on this device day in and day out, this can be also used as a refresher course on how does it work and what it does and what are the challenges, if there are any, and how can it be better utilized. So this can also be used for having a kind of quick reference, because I'm trying to keep the videos very short and concise so that you don't have to sit hour long to find out exactly what the content is. So I'm trying to be to the point and will not talk about anything that doesn't feel relevant to this topic. Also, it can be used as a training material to internal staff, especially if you are building up a team and want to onboard somebody new. Just let them run through this tutorial and they should be able to grasp most of the concepts. Also, like a student who is trying to get into the Oracle consulting profession, again, as I mentioned already about this, so it's always beneficial for people who's trying to seek knowledge on this area, because this is something very much helpful for them. Once they go through this training, they'll be able to understand the details on this particular application. All right, so going to the next slide, here I talk about a little bit on the architecture of MSCA. So you can see that the RF device, which typically runs the Telnet application, or Telnet application is a command prompt application that has a window where you, just like a application icon you'll see in the screen, you can just click, and once it is set up, you'll be able to log in using your own Oracle username password. And again, if your company has not enabled the self-service authentication, then you typically use the same Oracle username and password that you use to log in into your desktop. So that will take you through the screen. And again, that is basically communicating or connecting with your router, which is there in your facility. And that router is definitely connected to your LAN or WAN, the local area or the wide area network. And then that basically goes to the mobile server through the internet. So depending on where your data server is, where is your Oracle servers located, and within that topology, the mobile server is connected to the Oracle database server, and they do a kind of real-time communication between them. So as soon as, suppose you are doing some kind of inventory movement, and let's take an example that you are doing a sub-inventory transfer, then what it does, as soon as you're done, like once, as soon as you move the product from one location to another location, that same transaction gets recorded here and it gets reconciled to this Oracle database, the main ERP system. So immediately you will be able to see those transactions in the material transactions. And again, these are the different parts of Telnet handler and the presentation layer. And again, I don't want to go into those details because they are mostly for the, and again, if you are interested, you can do some search and find out what exactly it does. But ideally, it's just the way it handles the look and feel of the client or of the application which you see in the client, and they process the request coming from the client. So this is the client and this is the server. So just to make it clear, so these are the different components of that particular mobile server that handle those functions. So this is the gist of the architecture of MSCA. If again, this is something very, very simple, very high level, and I don't think you need to know any further details unless you are a part of the database administration or a part of server operations team. Like if you are a normal business analyst or a developer, or if you are a business user, then I believe this much information should be enough for you to understand the architecture and take it from here forward. So again, if you have any questions in this module, just put your comments and put your questions in the question Q&A section, and I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.